Hello folks, welcome to day 217 of the Streaming Day Challenge here on my channel. And hello, how you all doing? Just a quick apology for being late. I just realised the time. I really should stop going by the time that's on my laptop because we all know that that's an hour slow. Because I'm an hour and a half late, we are going to only be streaming some STO today. So, and that's because I have to head off at 4 today. So we've got about, what's that, two and a half hours. I had to just work that out. That pretty bad, wasn't it? Did I actually click that? No, apparently I didn't. So, yeah. We're streaming a bit of STO and then that's it for today, I believe. Or will we, as is STO maintenance? Huh. Damn it, STO. Yeah, so there's maintenance today. Crap. Game for Life, hi, welcome to the stream. Let's see how long we get. Should only be like half an hour. Wait. Well, that's my entire plans for today's stream. Screwed. I'd have to do maintenance during my stream. Slowly loading up. I'm not going to do what I did last time and put it on screen just for it to disappear again. Although apparently it's actually just going to stay there, okay. Cryptic always has bad timing. Yes, they do. First shoot just sent me a message saying stream. Right. Timeline's still secure. Good. Mine enemy. Are we looking for a temporal probe in this one? I wonder if we can actually complete the mission before maintenance. Whatever claimed this? Wait, we never got any dilithium. Let's have space weapons this time. But they're giving me more? Damn it. Yep. And these aren't as good as the ones that you've got. Okay. Replace all the beams with these. Wait, all of the beams? This is what I have, and these are what go on there. 205, 203. Yep, replace all the beams with these. All the beams. and we'll just discard these. Can I actually use these? I can, but probably shouldn't, and I can't with these. Great. Just because I can't hold them, I'll just discard them. Right, okay. Let's go. Find enemy. Captain, the rumors were targeting a magnesite mine in this area, but the list we recovered didn't have its exact coordinates. I know we're in the right area, but all of the moons in this system are inhabited, and our sensors are being affected by the magnesite. We'll need to contact each moon to try to determine which one the rumors were actually targeting. Great. You've stuck your nose in our business for the last time, Starfleet. Oh, okay. Well then. Is that the polarized hull? Yeah, okay, don't need that. My weapons aren't auto-fire. Great. Balance all the power out. Beam overloads. Emergency power to what? Boarding party. Ah, send over a boarding party. Oh, boarding party might as well come back. I don't want the magnesite ore. Go away with the magnesite ore. On to the next one. Went well. Really want me to scan the magnesite ore, don't they? This moon is private property, no solicitors, beggars, or Starfleet allowed. They're not very hospitable around here, are they? This is a dangerous area and it's only gotten worse since the destruction of Romulus. Might be difficult to get someone to trust us. Yes, but it seems. Ivac and Angry Kung Fu. At even, not and. Hailing Moon. Hello, my good friends. I'm so happy to meet you. Perhaps you're in the market for some high-quality magnesite. No, I really don't want any magnesite. We have the finest ore in the quadrant. On behalf of the miners and residents here, I'm more than happy to welcome you to our home. Please, transport to the surface. Unfortunately, the large amounts of extremely pure magnesite ore in the core of our little world will interfere with your sensors. For safety reasons, I must insist that you use the transporter signal enhancers that I have installed at my own expense. Also, I know you Starfleet types are so fond of your away teams, but could you please restrict the number of crew you bring down to the surface? My people here aren't used to strangers, and you wouldn't want to disrupt their work, would you? Okay, I guess we'll beam down. Take my first officer. Talk to Madran. Talk to Romulan refugee, why not? Please, have you seen my brother? Tell me about your life here. My life? My life is unimportant. It's my brother. I can't find him. Maybe I can help. How long has he been missing? I last saw him 2 days ago. Madran assigned both of us to work in the upper level of the mine. Ocean's drill bit broke, and he needed a new one. I know I should have went with him. It's not safe to be in the mine alone. Now he's gone. Well then. Doesn't open. You're a Romulan refugee as well. Ah, there we go. On behalf of everyone on this forsaken rock, let me be the first to welcome you to... Yeah. As you can see, we don't have time for pleasantries, and I'm not sharing my Trania stash with you, so why don't we skip the chit-chat and get down to business? Of course, I've heard you are an excellent source of magnesite. What makes your mine better than the others in the sector? Fortunately, I cannot call this mine my own. I'm just a middleman. Out of the goodness of my heart, I help the residents here pass on the products of their hard work to commercial entities such as yourself. The minuscule transaction fee and trade tariff I keep to offset my expenses is figured into the unit cost of the ore. My operation has become one of the best in the area because of the high demand for my services from both sides. I provide the best mining equipment and supplies in the sector to the miners, while my customers get competitive pricing on the ore they need. Do you have any more information about the mines themselves? I don't pay much attention to that. Miners have empty carts, and they return with ones filled with ore. If you're that interested, you could visit the mines themselves, but I don't recommend it. It's such a dirty, disagreeable business, and I'm convinced that breathing ore dust for too long is terrible for you. The miners who live near my quarters used to keep me up at night. Keep me up night after night with their dreadful coughing. I had to install soundproofing just to get some sleep. Are you sure you wouldn't rather look at the ore I have for sale? Thanks, but I'd like to talk to the miners first. Really? Do it yourself. Just remember, I have an exclusive contract to export magnesite ore from this moon. If you try to cut me out of your deals, you'll regret it. I just have a few questions before we conduct any business. I'll be back when I'm done. Madran won't answer any questions about why the Reavers might be targeting this place for fear of scaring us away from a possible sale. Perhaps if we ask some of the locals about what's going on here, they'll be able to provide more information. Sure. Well, I'll just run into them. Question miners. What am I being attacked by? Okay. Interesting. Didn't expect anyone to be shooting at me. I'm sorry, I can't really talk at the moment. I have to finish a survey of the area so miners can start work on a new mine shaft. Is there anything I can do to help? as much as I'd appreciate someone else to lug around this heavy equipment, it's all very delicate and I'd only trust a capable scientist to help me. If I encounter someone who can help, I'll send them your way. Okay. Can't talk to you. I can't talk to anyone. I'm on the run, and if those thugs see me talking to you, then you'll be in danger too. Anything I can do to help? I need someone who's not afraid of a fight. There's a group here that are beating and stealing from us. Madran doesn't do anything to stop it. For all I know, he's getting a cut of everything they take. They're making life miserable for all of us. Would you be willing to help? Count me in. There's a group of bullies that have been stealing from us. If we don't give them what they want, they beat us. I had a friend. All he was trying to do here was feed his family, be a good man. He had an old bottle of ale. He said it was from the homeworld. One of those thugs wanted it. Now my friend is dead. I'm too weak to stop them. I know that. And now I have my friend's children to feed in addition to my own. But if someone were to teach them a lesson, this camp would be a better place for all of us. Defeat thug gangs. Suppose I can. Don't have time to talk to you right now. I need to repair this drill so I can make a living. Anything I can do to help? Not unless you know an engineer who'd be willing to take a few moments out of their busy schedule to help me fix this hunk of junk. If I encounter anyone who can help, I'll send them your way. I could just call the Ziggy Stardust and get my chief engineer, but whatever. Now he's on the ground. Okay then. Nice. Can I not talk to him? No. Okay. Where are these other... that way somewhere. Okay. I don't think I can go through that door, can I? Around this way. Where's your money? No. What I would have done without you. What have I been hit with? Right, so up there somewhere. How do I get to that? Yes, this way. You walked down the wrong alley. No, I didn't. Return to bullied refugee. Which one was he? He's up this way somewhere, wouldn't he? Thank you. Those guys have been giving everyone a lot of trouble. These thugs are part of a larger group that operate deep inside the Magnesite mine. They control the lower levels, and no one who goes down there uninvited ever comes back. I don't know what's so important down there that it's worth hurting us to protect it. Maybe if you went down there, you could get some answers. Your tactical training has paid off. Return to Madrid. He's up here, right? Yep. Well, not him, but him. You want to go into the mine? Are you really interested in buying any magnesite, or are you just here to cause trouble? Because if it's the latter, I know someplace you can start a little ruckus. There's a gang that controls the bottom levels of the mine. They won't even let me in there. Previously, I allowed them to keep their little kingdom in exchange for information, but lately they've been more trouble than they're worth, and the intel they're feeding me is useless. Honestly, who doesn't know about the Breen invasion of Defari space? I'll take that information to heart. I'll take what? I may have just read something that wasn't there. What's he saying, please don't do? Imagine I get into the mine somewhere over here. Is this the biggest circle? And there's a door. And it says enter magnesite mine. Digging for answers. Ah, temporal probe somewhere in here. Looks wrong with the miner. What do you want? I'd like to enter this area. This area is restricted. Only people my friends and I like may enter, and I don't like you. Maybe if you got to know me a little better, you'd learn to like me. Wonder if you like my weapon? No. I'll shoot everything but him. There we go. That works. In a temporal probe anywhere. Okay. Continuing on. Oh, there seems to be a lot of them in here. Hello. I hate your weapons that do this to me. Just want to mention that. I've defeated 100 Romulans. Wow. No. Before this. Ow. Then my left click is stuck again. That was a person then pinned to the wall. Strange things going on in this mine. Oh, then that was of course, there's a medic. Should have known that. Right, let's pick up the things which have dropped over here. Don't want filled rations. No, I don't want that either. Let's not pick up the things which have dropped over here. I'm in campsite. Captain, there are a series of pressure plates located in this area. They are low-tech, but the Romulans may have had to resort to outdated security measures because of interference from the magnesite veins in this cavern. The problem is that the magnesite is making our tricorders almost useless. If there's anything on this moon that the Reamers would want to eliminate badly enough to use Thaleron weapons, it has to be here. We're going to have to figure out How to use the pressure plate to reveal whatever the Romulans are trying to hide. I suspect that we need to activate two of them to open the door. Okay. I need to set a rally point then, I guess. Oh, not there. Well, there. There we go. All right. There we go. Wait. As long as this door opens, I don't have to go through.
I give the orders here, Commander. You are out of line.
With all due respect, sir, there's a difference between protecting the Empire from her enemies and provoking...
There is much here you do not understand, Janik. The Remans need to know their place. As do you. I will not forget your insubordination, Commander. The Tal Shiar has no place for officers who cannot follow orders. I'll be in the command center.
Colonel! They were civilians! Their blood is on our hands!
Get used to it. There will be more. Speaking of which, why don't you clean out the brig before you become a resident there?
Nice people. Like how the other ones just stand there, not actually sounding the alarm or alerting security. Where's this temple probe anyway? Miner, captured miner, captured miner. Temple probe. Wait, is that me having missed it? Oh hello. Yeah, I don't believe that door opens yet, does it? Oh, it does. Hello. Ooh, a lockbox. Really must stop clicking those lockboxes. Sub-Lieutenant Medic, eh? Alright, let's scan this coronal distortion. Unlocking temporal probe. Don't be the mass one. Yes. Right. Name disruptor Worf, I'm guessing. And it's that one. Lies. Time chronoton tame. Time chronoton. Well, the actual word is right there. Huge juice pass. Huge juice pass. Oh, no. This temporal probe is tied in with the Tal Shiar data collection network. Looks like the Narkul were looking for Thedoran weapons research data. We can't let any of that fall into their hands. Shut the probe down. Opponent's Isolinia circuitry. Okay, let's go back and search these. Observe from holofeed and listening post. That. Janik is fighting with Hakiv again. Hakiv takes shuttle and leaves base for 2 days. Long range sensors mark his progress in neutral zone. 6 miners held for questioning. Chief medical officer reports 2 cases of Lavodian flu. 6 encrypted messages sent from Colonel Hakiv's console. The unknown recipient recommend the transmissions be investigated further. Okay. for the commander's code. Observe from Holofood on Cardassia Prime. The Tapa Council petitions Federation to fund Lucarian City infrastructure projects. 47 injured in bombing at University of Kalut. Uruguay claims responsibility for attack. Council passes bill allowing Cardassian government to seize assets of persons convicted of terrorist activity. Councillor Marim Okanda resigns. Starfleet sending advisors. Councillor, ministry, no code. Read logs on Borg activity. Observed from captured holo recordings in the Delta Quadrant. Resistance is futile. A lot of information there. Is this actually going to have any codes in it? Not looking likely. Read logs on Starfleet activity. Admiral Quinn under medical care for heart condition. Intercepted Starfleet medical records indicate that the condition is fully treatable and not a suitable target for exploitation. Well then. Alright, let's check this room, I guess. Probably done that whilst we're in here. Access console. Essen Krimen is dead. Hakeev ordered him to explore the tunnels. We found organic remains and his fully discharged disruptor was nearby. Looked like he had been melted. I think we should wall off this section of the mine and not disturb the creature down here. Six people have already died. Five were miners and therefore expendable. But Krimen, I don't even know if I'm saying that right, showed promise. I know that in the time he would have been a fine officer. I've asked Colonel Hakeev to request reinforcements. If he's determined to kill people exploring this mine, let him kill recruits. Well then. We were drilling near when we broke through a wall into a chamber that hadn't appeared on our scans. Massive magnetite blocks everything. Sensors, tricorders are all useless. The chamber is large and should be suitable for an expansion of the base. There were several spherical orbs in it. We have yet to determine the nature of these orbs, but Janik thinks they are pretty. She kept one for her quarters. I've asked for permission to study the orbs. They remind me of a Federation report I read once. I can't remember the details, but it was something about the Janus system. Okay. And we shall take that. Were there any consoles down here that we could access? There's a way to go. Hold up. Down the hole. This hole is tunneled through solid magnetite. It's too precise to be one of the mining tunnels, and there is a slight trace of silicon residue. Curious, Captain. There are not many creatures that could do something like this. Well then. Applying quick fix. Ah, shit, didn't realise I was still shooting us. Now, is this Horto gonna come for us? Imagine if we get too close, it'll probably kill us. Communicate with Horto. No kill, I. This message is burned deep into the floor of the chamber. Acid sizzles around the edges of the letters. You met a Horto. Not in this room. Wait, is there someone in this room? Have they been in this room this entire time? Let me see your clearance. You've not cared the entire time we've been running around reading things. Observe from Holofeed on Rotor 3. Cold.
I almost feel sorry for you, but I have my own neck to worry about. I'll be joining you in there soon enough. If Hakeev has his way, we all will.
Well then. Optional release prisoners. Right, let's find the code first and then release the prisoners. Or we'll just release the prisoners now. There we go. Okay. That's new. That hurts as well, actually. I'll just be over here dying.
Surrender. I value my life more than the Tal Shiar's secrets. I'll tell you anything you want to know. But first, you must tell me why you are here and what you want.
What does the Riemann Resistance want to destroy this base?
The Riemanns know about this base? Impossible. Only the leadership of the Tal Shiar know we're here. The Empress herself couldn't find us. I don't believe you. But it makes no difference. This is not a military installation. We listen and record here, nothing more. There are many targets those Riemann scum would find much more tempting.
I just realized the maintenance time was UTC. So it's in an hour, not now. Enough of these lies.
Are you sure you want to end things like this?
Yes, apparently. Find the base's control room. I think we don't need the code anymore then. Locking the door. Hello. I'm trying to murder you. Oh, the main people. There we go. A force field.
How did you find this place? What else do you know? No matter. You won't be revealing anything to your superiors.
Yes,
it's disappointing I cannot give you a proper interrogation. But I have much to do and little time. The self-destruct sequence has begun. This base will be your tomb.
Okay, what's... Download Telshiar records. The factory's going critical, we need to get out of here. Escape from the mines. Run. One silent door. I'm not even sure if this is the way we came in, but hopefully it is. Watch out for falling stuff. Rocks and stuff. I'm numb of this. None of this is landing on me. Gift return. Confront Madran about the Tal Shiar base. Where's Madran? Still up here? My mind! What have you done to my mind? That was an infestation of Tal Shiar spies in there. I just fumigated. I didn't do anything, it was the Tal Shiar cell you were sheltering. Tal Shiar? I am shocked. Look, I had no idea. I certainly wouldn't have sent you down there if... Say, you didn't happen to find anything valuable down there, did you? Because if you did, remember that I have an exclusive contract. Stop with the lies, Madran. I know you knew who and what was down there. And what's it to you? This is a rough area, quadrant, you know, and they're good neighbours, if you're not easily embarrassed. Their cameras and listening devices are everywhere. I haven't had a single problem with Orions or Herogians since they moved in, and it doesn't hurt that I acquired the odd bit of information here and there. I'm a businessman, and information is big business. Do you know anything about what they recently discovered? Unfortunately, no. I'll admit I was trying to find out, but their systems were locked down tight. I'm sure whatever it was had to be big news. Everyone was on edge. Janik and Hakeev were barely speaking, and I once heard Hakeev mumbling something about orders. Someone's been pulling his strings, but I don't know who. I do know the Tal Shiar take security very seriously. If you manage to pull any files from their system, you can expect them to be heavily encoded. Trust me on that. I speak from experience. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go talk 100 Romulans into digging a new mine to replace the one you destroyed. My profit margin for this month is ruined. Been a real help, Madran? Get this mine as well, Madran, or I'll be back. Madran doesn't seem to know much, Captain, or at least he's not willing to part with what information he knows without being paid. I don't think he can help us anymore. We should return to the ship and try our luck at decrypting the files we recovered from the Tal Shiar. I'm sure they'll be more useful than anything Madran has to say. I'm sure. If you start us two to beam up. Energize. Oh, I don't want to patrol the system. Decipher Tal Shiar files in your ready room. Starship bridge. What bridge do I have, actually? That's interesting. Guess we are in sector space after all. That's... I just presumed that would be my ready room. Here we go. I'll use this computer. New next duty officers. That's the library files. The cipher Tal Shiar files. My files uploaded. Okay. Further war. Activities of note in Klingon space. Analyze file structure. No anomalies. Cross-reference to Starfleet records. Inaccuracy found. The House of Torg lost its seat on the Klingon High Council after evidence was revealed that the House leaders collaborated with Romulans to attack the House of Martok. Change faulty information. Okay, maybe I just changed the wrong stuff then. Analyze file structure. File is encrypted using a multivariable passkey that references the other files uploaded. Okay. Select a new file. Cross-reference to Starfleet records. Inaccuracy found. Ambassador Soketh was revealed to be an Undine infiltrator after a Starfleet vessel transported him to the monitor for Gem. Change faulty information. Vulcan Ambassador Soketh retires to Monastery of Pajem. Retires to exposed out. Changes made. Open file. Analyze structure. Oop. Analyze file structure. Partial number sequence found in officer ID numbers. Numbers the sum of the previous two file is referenced by another file. Okay. Change faulty information. No idea, we're just gonna guess. There we go. Cross-reference to Starfleet records. Next, Starfleet has no record of Ambassador Durak visiting Andoria. Vulcan? Okay. Open this file, analyze file structure, apply passkey. The data passkey applied. Analyze file structure. File's encrypted using, yeah. I'll just keep clicking apply. Oh, okay. Secret Riemann base detected in the DIRA system. Listening posts, yes, has detected an increase in subspace communication and ships travelling to and from the DIRA system. Analysis of the communications and ship traffic reveals patterns of obfuscation normally employed by Riemann forces. The Tal Shiar forces that intercepted a new ship leaving the DIRA system and captured 47 Riemann civilians. The passengers and crew were summarily executed under orders of Colonel Hakeev. The captain and first officer were preserved for questioning. Under interrogation, the captain of the Riemann vessel provided a security key that could be used to decipher encrypted communications sent to the DIRA system. Decrypted messages prove that there is a base in this area of space being used by the Riemann resistance. Recommendation: Tal Shiar ships should be sent to the DIRA system immediately to capture this base and its inhabitants. Tal Shiar is planning an attack on a Riemann base. We need to get this information to Admiral Tenet at Starbase 39 Sierra immediately. Why do I now have a mission to secure
that? The Tal Shiar records you recovered show that Hakeev and his forces have been targeting the Riemanns for months. Obasek and his followers have been driven from their homes, had their ships destroyed, and their loved ones killed or imprisoned. Some might say that Obasek's campaign against the Tal Shiar is just. However, Obasek was planning on using Thaleron weapons in the Fahar system, which would have killed hundreds of innocent civilians, as well as the Tal Shiar cell there. This is the problem with revenge. Violence and fury only create more pain and suffering.
Congratulations, Admiral.
Duty officers. I'm sure I don't actually have to do the system patrol right now. We'll drop it. I'd like to leave the ship in Tyra. Right, where are we on these?
We know from the information you recovered from the Vahar system that the Tal Shiar are planning to attack a Riemann settlement in the Dera system. We have an opportunity to reach the settlement first. This may be a completely internal matter, and if so, the Prime Directive will come into play. We will not be able to interfere. But if there is an outside influence directing these matters, we must know what it is. Our encounters with the Undine and the Changelings have proven that there are entities attempting to move the powers of the Quadrant like pieces in a Kal-To game. It is essential to protecting the Federation to see these attempts for what they are and counter them. I want you to go to the Dera system and learn more about the Riemann Uprising. The Riemanns will have hidden their base, so you may have to use subterfuge to find it. One more thing. I realize this is a dangerous situation and that you may be drawn into conflict, but do not antagonize the Riemanns or the Romulans if you can avoid doing so. We are already at war with the Klingon Empire. I would prefer to avoid another extended conflict.
I'll try to. Let's transwarp. Should I have a starting thing anywhere? Begin frozen. There we go. Admiral, the Riemanns are jamming our sensors, and there is no way to determine where their base is located without assistance. We need a guide. Sensors are picking up a communication satellite nearby. We should be able to modify it to emit a signal that the Riemanns will think is from one of their ships. When the Riemanns send someone to investigate the signal, we can get a sensor lock on their ship and follow them back to their base. Okay. We'll use the comm array. Micronebula is a limiting sensor function. We can use it to hide from the Riemann ship when we send the fake distress signal. Sounds good. Altering the array. Modifications are complete, Admiral. When we trigger the transmission, the Riemanns should think it's from a vessel that is losing power and needs assistance. There's a micronebula aft of our location that should be sufficient to conceal the Ziggy Stardust's energy signature while we wait for a Riemann guide to arrive. Do I have to get into the nebula? Okay. Slowly turning. Or turning. One second. Shit. Let me just close that there so it doesn't keep making a sound. Right. That was not how you throttle up. Let's see if I can actually make it into the nebula this time. All stop. Send the signal. Signal work, Captain. Riemann scout ship in range. Moving to scan the area. I have a sensor lock on the Riemann vessel. We'll be able to track it if it goes to warp. Detecting a large energy build-up, sir. It's near the Riemann ship. Romulans, the battleship is powering disruptors, Captain. Should we go to red? Villa? Captain, they're firing on the Riemann ship. Redhood 2016, hi, welcome to the stream. Rumors of cloaking, sir. Attempting to re-establish sensor lock. Captain, the Reaman ship has cloaked, but its engines are damaged and sensors are detecting a tachyon leak. They can't stay hidden for long. If we distract the Romulans, then the Reamans will have a chance to decloak and go to warp. Otherwise, I don't think they can last long against the Romulans. If the Reaman vessel is destroyed, we'll lose our best chance at finding the base. Okay. So I can't go to full impulse in the micro-nebula. Captain, incoming hail from the lead Romulan vessel. They know we're here. Putting it on the main view screen now.
Vengeance for the homeworld.
That's all you're going to say, okay? Ah, the famed USS Ziggy Stardust. You're a good distance out of your Federation's territory, aren't you? Offer no aid or assistance to these Reaman rebels and leave this system immediately. If you do so, I can overlook your intrusion into an internal affair. Otherwise, I will be forced to see your presence here as an invasion of Romulan territory. That would be unfortunate for you. Is that a Klingon or are those Romulan? Romulan. Let's polarize the whole plating. I have no idea where my brace for impact is. Is that it? Yes. Okay. Always moves. This is gonna hurt. A little bit. Not much. Okay. Approach Reaman Scout. Will do once I've turned around. Admiral, the Reaman scout ship has decloaked. They'll try to shake us. We need to stay close until we get a lock on the ship's warp signature. Reaman ship is on the move, sir. We should follow it. Trying to. Slow down to stay behind it. Red Hood 2016, thank you for following. Oh, well. Reaman Scout is cloaking, sir. Romulan forces warping in. Shields aren't looking very good there. Let's find evasive maneuvers. Why do they move everything every time I change ship? Okay, I'd very much like to get away from that before it explodes. And they just walked into an asteroid by the looks of it. Reaman ship has executed a short warp jump and have a lock on its coordinates, sir. We can engage warp as soon as you're ready. Follow the scout. I'm not picking up any ships here, Admiral, but I wouldn't be surprised if there are one or more cloaked ships in the area. Reaman cloaked ships can appear as concentrations of tetrion particles. I'll continue scanning the area. There is something interesting on the planet's surface, however. Sensors are detecting a large underground installation. It could very well be the base that the Reman Resistance is using. The entire area is protected by a magnetic shield, though, so we can't transport inside. There is a series of caverns connected to the installation. We could send an away team there and try to find a way to disable or circumvent the magnetic shielding. Sounds good. Full away team. Let's go. Admiral, this is incredible. The underground cavern we are in is natural, but the base itself, it's a ship. The Derridex class. If my tricorder readings are correct, the Remans moved a derelict vessel into the cavern. We appear to be in a maintenance area adjacent to the hull of the ship. The Remans probably mine these tunnels for raw materials. I'm picking up material veins of ore, multiple veins of ore, that could be useful if they are replicating ship parts or weapons. I'm not reading any way into the ship from here, though we'll need to find an entrance. Okay. Just said that before I walked into its mouth, pretty much. Open season. Oh wait, there's a temporal probe. Temporal probe is in this room, to the left. Good. So are these things. Temporal probe looks weird in here. Please don't be the mouth swan. This one may actually be worse. Alright, first digit. One. There's no one in this code. Two. No two. Three? There's a three somewhere. Four. Crap, I actually wanted the four still. Test. Okay, so we have the first one. Now is the second one the three that we know is somewhere? It is. Third one. Five. That was a guess. Okay, no. Is it a two? No. We should know this, actually. Four? No. Right, one. Is there a number I've just not tried? No, don't change the second digit. Three. Keep that as three. Well, we'll try three on this one. Oh. Four. No. Five. I'm sure now I've gone through all of them. Alright, we'll just leave that as a one for now then. Fourth digit. We'll also have as a one test series. No. Two. Three. Okay, so now we've just got to find the third one. Still. Let's go through all of them again, I guess. There we go. Narkul have been sending operatives to infiltrate the Riemans. With cosmetic alterations, it'd be difficult to tell a Narkul and a Riemann apart. According to this probe, there's a Narkul operative here trying to sabotage the old warp core used to power this base. Let's find and stop the operative before he takes out the resistance for good. Ooh. His abandoned lab station was probably used to refine the ore the Riemans collected while creating this maintenance tunnel. Could be. Right. Where are we going here? Not wherever I'm trying to run to. This way. All of them. Stop Narkul from sabotaging the Riemann base. This tunnel leads directly into the main area of the base, sir, but it's completely blocked. I wonder if a weapon on its highest setting would breach it. What about that? Okay, we'll just scan the gate. There's a drilling thing there. This gate is made of tritanium alloy, Admiral. There's no way a hand weapon will blast through it. We need something with a lot more power. That's it. Sir, did you see the mining laser? Yes, I pretty much ran into it. If it's operational, we might be able to modify it to do the job. I think the controls for the laser are on the other side of this wall. By other side of this wall, do you mean all the way around here? You do, yeah. I don't face the controls when I use them. Malfunctioning. Engaging automatic shutdown. Something must be wrong with the mining laser, sir. We should perform a more detailed scan to determine the source of the problem. Scan mining laser. Admiral, the mining laser's power system isn't strong enough. We won't be able to cut through tritanium. I think there are several different ways we can fix this. Your career training will help. Tactical. Your applied tactics instructor always told you to use whatever was available to get the job done. You think you could modify the power cell of a hand weapon to boost the output of the mining laser? Starfleet weapons aren't compatible, but the Riemans might have something left suitable in the cave. Ooh, I just collect stuff from everywhere. Great. No. Not ice spiders, not ice spiders. Ice spiders. Why does every new species we encounter have to be spiders? Deal with them. Better not be luring them out here. Saw a horrible thing on Facebook today. In a way, I guess it's good, but the video they showed of it was a spider catcher thing. Of course, they showed it catching spiders. It was a horrible thing to watch just after I woke up. Any more weapons parts? Oh, right there. Actually, I think this is just a crate that I could have searched earlier. Yep. Saw that spider. Okay. You have all the power cells you need, but before you can use them to boost the output of the mining laser, you'll need to fuse them together and install a single control unit that is strong enough to handle the burst of power without burning it out. Okay. I can only fuse them over here. It's power packs. Are we gonna vent heat out or something? Fake fused power packs. The combined power pack is now ready to use. All you need to do now is install it in the mining laser and cross your fingers. Why do I feel like the mining laser was behind there? It's not. In the wrong room. Right. Modify mining laser. That did it, sir. Power to the mining laser is steady and it should be ready to fire. Great. Why are you in stealth mode? What the hell? Personal cloaking device. Use mining laser. I still don't face the console when I use it. It just causes a cave-in or something. Success! The path inside the Reuman base is clear, Admiral. The Reumans will be alerted to our presence, so we will need to be careful. But I have a feeling that Obersek wants to see us. I felt much safer if we'd just completely shut that down before running in front of it, but hey. Why are you here, outsider? Ask your questions. I will answer. Tell me about your life here. The nights are cold and there's not enough food. It is a place like any other. For now, we are safe from the Tal Shiar, but I fear that will soon change. Why are you fighting the Romulans? My wife was working on a mining ship. This was not a military vessel, it had no weapons and limited shields. It was not in restricted space, and it threatened no one. The Tal Shiar captured it and questioned everyone on the crew for weeks. My wife died screaming in a Tal Shiar interrogation chamber. I fight for her. What do you want when this conflict ends? What do I want? I cannot answer that question. All I wanted, all I will ever want, died with my wife. Oh, right, yeah. Get ya. Carry on. Rumors seem to have been expecting us. Perhaps we should have just knocked? Potentially. How about your life here? No, that's okay. Why are you fighting? You all say the same things. Same stuff. Got you. Or I'm talking to the exact same person I just spoke to. Base is remarkable. The Reumans must have disassembled the old ship. Disassembled the old ship and beamed pieces in one by one to construct it. Wow. Reading apparently is not my strong point. I'm just gonna search this crate, don't mind me. Or not. You're then our cool commander. Gotcha. Oh, you're gonna do that stupid thing. Hey. Not allowed to fall down there. Okay. Now we'll search this crate. We shall take all. Expected that door to open. Guess there's another way in. Like, right here? No. What about... right here? Why'd you follow Obersek? Obersek has a vision. He wants all Reemans to be free from Romulan oppression. He wants us to have a world of our own, and not to have to beg for scraps from the Romulans' tables. Obersek will lead us to victory. I, for one, am happy to fight at his side. Are there people here who aren't happy with Obersek's leadership? Many of the people here have lost family members to the Tal Shiar. It's hard to be happy about anything when all you're thinking about is what you don't have. What do you want out of this war? I want out. I will fight Bobsek's side until we are free, but then I want to explore. I've had enough of despair. There are hundreds of ships that need a capable warrior. I will find one of them, leave this space, and never look back. Perhaps I will join the crew. Perhaps I will join the crew of a Starfleet vessel. Cool. I suppose you could tell me how to get to Bobsek. You know, just feel like I should be through that door. Do I need to just keep talking to people until I find a way in? Let's look at the full map, actually. Okay. But we're just going to have to talk to people until we're going to be able to get in. Hi. You're not wanted here, outsider. You have questions? Fine, ask them, and then go. Why don't you want us here? Obersek says we must trust you. He says we need allies and that the Federation will help us. I do not believe him. If I have learned anything in my long years, it is that outsiders cannot be trusted. In the end, you will turn on us like vipers. Why do you think Obersek is wrong? I am old, and I have seen much. I fought with Shinzon, and he was obsessed with outsiders. He risked everything in a useless attack on the Federation. If he had thought more about our people and less about his hatred for humans, he would control the Empire today. Instead, we have nothing. This is what comes from dealing with outsiders. What do you want? I want peace, outsider, and I want quiet. All of my family and friends are dead. I have no stake in this rebellion. I fight because that is all I know how to do. But this battle is my last. Whenever it is over, I will find someplace dark, and I will stay there for the rest of my days. If you have questions? Fine, ask them then, okay? The same questions there. Wait, that door opened. Sweet, that was just a side door the entire time.
This place won't be safe forever. We have to be ready to leave at a moment's notice. Prepare the... Ah, it's you. Welcome to the heart of the Resistance, little spy. There is so much for us to discuss, and so little time. The Tal Shiar have discovered this, our last refuge. They will be here soon, and my people and I will have to fight for our lives. Yet one question remains. Will you be our friend, or our enemy?
Okay, confront Obersek.
My hope is that you are here to talk. But I am prepared for the alternative. The Tal Shiar could arrive at any time. Speak quickly.
The Solar Order these attacks.
This campaign of terror is the Tal Shiar's doing, not the Empress's. Still, Sela does nothing to stop it. There is little love between the Empress and the Tal Shiar. Did you know that many years ago, she was exiled from Romulus for attempting to assassinate the head of their order? The Tal Shiar have their own masters, and Sela despises what she cannot control. Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Why do you think the Tal Shiar are doing this?
Hakiv and the Tal Shiar no longer serve the Empire. The demons of air and darkness are their masters now. They whisper in the night for chaos and despair, and Hakiv gives them blood as tribute. Our blood. Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Why are you doing this? Why fight the Tal Shiar?
Why? You ask why? This place is one of the last sanctuaries left to my people, and even it is lost to us now. The Romulans have driven us from our homes, destroyed our ships, and captured or killed our loved ones. They seek to exterminate us, and we will not go quietly. Understand, I do not want this war. I want freedom for my people. It is the Romulans and the Dark Masters they serve who have caused this. Now they must suffer the consequences. Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Tell me more about these demons.
I have never seen one of these demons, and I will not speak their name, but I know they exist. Eons ago, they ruled this part of the galaxy. After thousands of years of tyranny and death, the races they ruled rose up against them, driving them from their home world into unexplored space. We thought they had been destroyed. We were wrong. The demons of air and darkness survive, and they hunger for revenge.
The Alachi.
Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Do you still have the Solar Run weapons?
A small supply. They are terrible things. Weapons of war so horrible, they should have never been invented at all. But they were. And my enemies are great. If I must resort to barbarism to free my people, that is not too high of a price to pay. Is there anything else you wish to ask?
Have you tried to find a peaceful solution?
There will be no peace. Not while Hakiv lives. This is not a problem that can be solved by diplomacy. Hakiv kills my people, I kill his. That is how it will be, until one of us is dead. Is there anything else you wish to ask?
What do you want from me?
We need your help. Talk to Starfleet Command. Tell them what you have seen. Tell them if my people are to survive, we need assistance. Starships, soldiers, medicine, protection for the refugees. I'm asking for the Federation's aid. You claim to be an organization dedicated to freedom for all peoples. Tell me, will you help my people now? Is there anything else you wish to ask?
I may not agree with your tactics, but I will not stop you.
I am glad you see things my way. Get instructions from your commanders if you must, but the battle rages, and we must join it. With your help, my people will be free. I'm pleased you see that my cause is just. We can do great...
Romulan transporter signals detected.
I will return to my ship and attempt to hold off their forces. Help my soldiers defend this base. Start the evacuation. We must get the civilians out.
The Tal Shiar have entered the base.
Commander Roshna, transport the reinforcements here. Tell them to assist our new ally.
Security forces transporting.
Fight well, my friend. My people are counting on you.
Emeril, we've lost our transporter lock on you and the away team. The Tal Shiar must have activated a transport inhibitor. You'll need to find that inhibitor and shut it down. Okay. This way. Nope. We have to go out that door and round. Hey, when they get back up just to die. Alright. Just gonna take the small hypo, don't mind me. Damn, that stuff's hard to walk over. Oh. I'm shooting my own people. Whilst they're targeting the Romulan resistance, disabling transport inhibitor. Boom should be able to handle it from here, Admiral. We should return to the ship and report to Admiral Tenet. Obersek trusts us. I don't know if he's right about the outside influence on Haki's actions, but I'm sure that he believes these demons are real. If there is someone directing Haki to attack the Remans, this is... bloody hell. This isn't a purely internal matter now, and the requirements of the Prime Directive aren't as clear. Even if he's wrong, Obersek is asking for the Federation's help. Without it, the Remans may be exterminated. Are we supposed to simply ignore genocide? No, don't beat me out yet. There's a lockbox. I don't want the shield, but I want the lockbox. Which I cannot open, so there's absolutely no point in me taking the lockbox, but hey. Biggie Stardust. Beam is up. Energize. Okay, report to Admiral Tenet.
I sympathize with Obersek's plight, but I do not know if we will be able to assist him. He has no proof of these demons that he claims are directing Haki's actions. Without that, becoming directly involved in this conflict would be a violation of the Prime Directive. We will protect the Federation, offer aid to the refugees, and keep this conflict from spilling over into our territory. But if Obersek and his followers are going to continue this fight, they will do so without Starfleet support.
Okay. I'll take that. A reward.
Congratulations.
I agree with you. There is more to this story, and we must continue to follow the trail until all is revealed. As I have said, directly assisting the Remans against the Tal Shar would be interfering with an internal affair, and that is prohibited by Starfleet regulations. However, I will authorize you to continue investigating this matter. If you can find evidence that supports Obersek's claims, then more options will be open to us.
Okay, we're being held by Obersek, putting him on screen now. Your resistance is very much in need of your help.
My contacts tell me that Starfleet has rejected my request for military assistance. That is regrettable, but not unexpected. The Tal Shiar are formidable opponents, as are the forces directing their action. I understand why the Federation would hesitate to engage them directly. So today I appeal to you, not as an ally in battle, but as a person of compassion. My people need your help. I need your help. One of our ships was carrying a load of Thaleron weapons through the Nopata system. That ship has disappeared. There are no indications there was a battle. It is as if my ship and its cargo simply vanished. I know you have your reservations about the lengths to which I will go to secure the freedom of my people. Tell me, if you do not trust me with Thaleron weapons, do you want Harkiv to have them? I can provide you with the last coordinates of the vessel. Please help me. Do what you will with the weapons, if they survive. But find my people.
Accept. Okay. We will start flying over to the start location of that mission. But as STO is going down for maintenance in 10 minutes, as that message just said, I think we shall end here for today. I would have carried on with the stream, but I kind of forgot that today is Thursday and there is maintenance on a Thursday, and I plan to play STO all day. So, yeah. Next time I should probably think my plans through a little bit better. Yeah, apologies about the short stream today. tomorrow, Friday, at 12, usual time. I'll try and actually be on time. Should probably stop here. Let's quit the game quick. Yes, I'll try and actually be on time tomorrow. But yeah, I am going to end the stream here for today. Short stream, but I would have had to head off in an hour anyway, so might as well end here as I'm not sure what to play. Instead of spending like half an hour finding something to play, I need to play it for 30 minutes. So next stream is Friday at 12 noon BST, and that'll be day 218. So yeah, we'll pick up some more SEO tomorrow, probably play some more construction sim or something. We'll shoot FSX, I don't know. There'll be games tomorrow, basically. Yeah, that is all for today. So, massive thank you to those who joined me today, and massive thank you to those who followed. If you are new to the channel and haven't done so already, please consider hitting the follow button. Follow the channel, follow Twitter, subscribe to YouTube, all that fun stuff, links below the channel. You can subscribe to the channel if you wish to do so over on GameWisp, gamewisp.com/account603. Completely optional, of course. Yeah, as I said, I'll be back tomorrow, 12 noon BST. Do hope to see you tomorrow. I was your sweetest escape. Wanted to come away with me and sneak out late in the night, not tell anybody. Start the car, take a ride out of this city. But you couldn't stay. Take back all your shiny